After having an argument over whether it's cannibalism for me to eat fish and then having to lay down with an ice pack on my back for a half an hour, I decided to post here again. This happened a few months ago. No kids make an appearance in this story, but the parental status of M does play a factor. The cast. Me, M, B asterisk TCH. So I'm just doing my normal weekend thing. I got lunch and went to a public park to eat. It was allowed and they had trash cans. Don't worry, when I get the alert on my phone that it's time for me to take my meds, I have them on me, so I take them. Apparently M saw this. M, why are you taking drugs in front of my kids? Me, fear my medications. I need them to not perpetually wanna jump off a cliff. M, you just need to cheer up. Me, yes, cheering up will fix the brain bullshit I have going on and erase my trauma. Thanks, I'm cured. Never thought about that. M, I'm calling the cops for you doing drugs. I just nod and finish up my lunch. The cops arrive while I'm on my way out and I tell them it's just my meds and show them the bottle. They let me go. I don't know what happened to M, but I'm hoping they find her for misuse of emergency services. This happened on a family vacation years ago. We went down to Texas near the Gulf, since I have never seen a beach. Wasn't that impressive, since it was a Gulf. Anyways, near the end of the trip I saw this beautiful hermit crab in a store, not a wild one, that had stripped legs and a green color. I had enough money to buy him, and I did. I was in the parking lot after when my cousins, who are all young boys, like 8, come up to me. Here's the cast. M, my stepmother, surprise Romeo. C1, cousin 1. C2, cousin 2. Me, yes. C1, oh, can we see him? Me, no. C2, but why? I. Me, you got money? C2, no. Me, then go away, I already have to keep him calm for the 12-hour drive. C1, I'm telling mom you aren't sharing. Even though she is their aunt, she's been a mom figure to them. Me, cool. Well, my mom comes storming over, which for a 5'2" woman is oddly scary. M, why aren't you letting them hold Larry? Me, first of all his name is Tyrone, and because I'm not comfortable with any of my pets around children, let alone a little crab. M, I'll tell your father you've been misbehaving all vacation. Me, he literally can't do anything but okay. After that I made the tragic decision to put Tyrone the crab in the car while I went to catch more waves at the beach, since it was next to the shop. When I came back, lord behold, the 2 kids were rolling him around in the sand and salt water. I lost it. Even though I only had him a maximum of an hour, he was mine and I love that Shelly boy. Me, what the fuck are you doing? Get in the goddamn car, you shit stains. M, what's your language? Why are you such an angry girl? Me, they were hurting my crab. M, so they are just kids, they didn't know better. Me, when I was their age I wasn't abusing animals or even touching them without permission. M, they had permission from me. Me, I told them no. It was my money and now it is wasted. M, I'll pay you back later, but you have to apologize. Me, or you can pay and I won't tell that you went against my word and killed my pet basically. M, whatever. We are going back to the hotel. Now I also want to say that this whole time I was holding my barely alive crab. Though at the end, when I looked down, Tyrone was dead. Legs missing, cracked shell, just awful. I did what you would have seen in sad movies and tossed his remains into the ocean. No way was I putting him in the car with those crotch goblins. But yeah, that was my story. Put an F for Tyrone. Cast. Me equals take a guess. M equals mom. J equals cousin, working on the garage sale with us. K equals aunt, also working with us. M equals entitled mother. X equals entitled kid. We held a garage sale this morning that went from 8 a.m. to 6 p.m. The sale has a steady stream of 3 to 5 people at a time, but it was relatively uneventful until about 11:30. I was working the cash register for a majority of the time, and I found people watching interesting from that perspective. My mom was working at the register with me, while my cousin and aunt were walking around everything, reorganizing and such. At about 11:30, a mother, M, and her son, Ek, came walking up. I need to mention, now that fear both African American, as it's an important detail for later. They did the expected browsing, M looked through clothes and home decor, while Eck looked at the toys, games, and books. I take a quick lunch break, so I switch out with my cousin, and I walk around the side of the garage, and into the house. I get to the kitchen, when I hear the door open and close, then footsteps up the stairs. I assume it's my mom, so I keep filling my plate. The door opens one more time, and I hear my mom say, "My name, are you in here?" I respond with a yes, and she asks who just came in here. I get up to see what she's talking about, and I can see both my aunt and my cousin are at the register. I realize that means that it wasn't my aunt, cousin, or mom that just walked into our house, or that my mom was playing a cruel joke on me, which I felt wasn't likely. So now someone we don't know is in our house, and that's probably one of the scariest feelings. My mom goes back outside, and I go upstairs. I specifically remember closing every door upstairs, my bedroom, mom's bedroom, spare bedroom and bathroom, but the door to the spare bedroom is open slightly. I peek into the room expecting either a creepy old man, or a ghost, but it turns out to be Eck. Eck is just laying on the futon couch, watching TV. Hey? I say to him. Eck just looks up at me then looks back at the TV. "Why are you in here?" I ask him. Eck doesn't acknowledge me at all this time. "Hey, I asked you a question," I say sternly. Eck doesn't do anything again. I walk over to him, and grab the remote and turn off the TV. He sits up, and stares at me, intensely. The front door opens again. "Get out. This isn't your house, kid. I'm so glad my aunt came into the house when she did, because she heard and came up." "Who's this?" Kay asks me. "Some kid. I think his mom's outside," I respond. "Do you know where your mom is?" Kay asks Eck. Kay walks towards Eck, and grabs his hand. She pulls him up, and takes him outside. I follow them outside, cause I'm curious what's gonna happen, and I can tell this will make a great Reddit story, and watch Kay reunite Eck and M. It wasn't as happy, if a reunion as I thought however. "M, unhand my son. Come here, kid's name." M walks over to her. "Kay, why was he in the house?" Sternly. "M, well that other boy walked into your house, so why can't my son? Is it because he's black?" "Yes, she really stooped to the level." "Kay, mom, he lives here. Your son does not." "M, I don't care, you can't kick my son out just because he's black." Jay finally snaps and says, "Listen here B*TCH. We never said anything about you being black, and we never said anything about having a problem with you being black. And your son can come into our house, because no one gave him any permission. We can, and we'll call the cops, if this happens again." "M, you can't kick his for being black, we'll come back with a lawyer for racial discrimination." Jay, F*CKING try me. M, scoffs. "Come on, kid, let's get away from these racist pricks." The two walked away quickly. Luckily, no one else was there to see the scene. We continued the garage sale like normal for a few more hours. So it was a pretty eventful day. This happened last night, while I was at the grocery store doing my weekly shopping. I was waiting in line behind a woman in her mid-30s pushing a double pram and a large shopping cart which was overflowing. After the groceries were scanned and packed, she tried to pay with two cards which both declined. She made the cashier try the first card twice as she said, "Sorry, this is a new card." This turned out to be a lie as her second card also declined, but with no excuse this time. She didn't have a single bill in her wallet. Here is where the entitlement starts. Once she realized she has no way of paying, she starts saying, "I'm so sorry, I'll pay for it next time. Print the bill up, and I'll pay for it next time I'm in the store." This is Stop and Shop right, a chain supermarket lol. The poor attendant is trying to tell her that they don't let people take groceries and pay later, so she starts to become aggravated and starts taking it personally, saying, "You are trying to make my family starve this week," and starts pushing the pram and the massive cart out past the register at the same time jerking them both back and forth as she has one arm on either. Needless to say, the manager and a fellow customer stop her at the door and advise her to leave before they called the police. She then put two hands on the cart leaving the pram, and attempted to push it past the two people in her way. When the manager and member of the public stood in front of her shopping cart, she realized she wasn't getting away with it this time. She then snuffed her nose upwardly, and starts violently jerking the pram to turn it around, and screams into the manager's face that she is going to Shaw's next time. Needless to say, the manager was like, thank fuck. The kids were in tears the whole time, so you can imagine what a scene this was. Not entirely sure if this falls into web story, but remembered this from a while back, and thought I'd share. This happened in the early 2000s, when my friend was working as a cashier in a shopping chain store. M equals mother, MF equals my friend, SG equals security guard. MF was on register 1, the closest register to the exit door about 20 feet away, when a woman, M, and her largest roller with her young toddler in it, walked through the first exit doors as the store alarm went off. This is a store with a one section room area you enter first, where the carts are stored, to walk through to enter the actual store area. Everyone stopped and looked at her, but M turned around, no concern on her face, and spoke aloud to MF on the register, nearest employee she could see. She started waving her flip phone up high to the registers and shouted, "Oh, it was just my cell phone." MF told me that sometimes, back then, in the early 2000s, cell phones would occasionally set off the security sensors at the exit doors, so it was a common thing to see. MF did a quick nod, when suddenly and at a breakneck speed, one of their co-workers and SG came running from the back of the store, and charged in front of the woman before M could get out through the next set of exit doors to the parking lot. Both SG and the co-worker are blocking her from leaving now, as her young toddler begins crying. The M becomes frantic and starts to lose her cool. This is what MF told me they heard. "M, please, it's just my cell phone. Let me through." SG: "Ma'am, we need to check your belongings." M: "I told you, it's my phone." SG: "Ma'am, I need to check." M: "Why? Let me out." SG: "Ma'am." MF at this point said M started ramming the stroller with her toddler in it against the SG and co-worker, as her child is now screaming. The SG at this point had to restrain her before she hurt her own child in the chaos, and M was screaming at the top of her lungs, "Let go," to unhand her and to not hurt her child either. Turns out, on the security footage, SG saw her acting suspicious, went looking for M, but she was gone from the section. So he questioned the co-worker in the section M was just in and investigated. Then immediately they both knew when the alarm went off at the doors. Found out M was piling several DVDs and CDs into her child's stroller, hoping she could get away with it with the cell phone gimmick. Don't know what happened after that, but it's pretty darned entitled and screwed up to use your own kid as a decoy to steal, then ram that kid into others to try to escape. What morals? If you enjoyed the stories, slap the like and subscribe button for more of them, and don't forget to support the original writers with an upvote. Links are in the description. Peace out, and catch you tomorrow.